In this video, we will be covering how to work with engaged calls within the Connect application. If you are using the combined platform, agents can take engaged calls directly from the Connect application without having to open the Engage agent. If the agent is already an assigned agent on the account, simply log in to the Connect app and navigate to the headset icon along the left sidebar. From here, the agent will click Join as Agent, and they will be logged in. Once logged in, the agent will be able to go available or choose a status from the available drop-down menu. In addition to the status selections, agents will also log out of Engage from here. From this home screen, agents can see the queues that they are assigned to as they would when using the Engage agent. They can choose to see all queues or only queues that have calls that are exceeding the expected hold time. They can select to also view their own personal statistics by selecting My Stats near the top of the window. While on a call or waiting for a call, the agent may choose to use the other features of Connect as well, such as checking chat or call history. If the agent needs to place an outbound call, they can select Dial Out from the home screen. Doing so will take them to a dial-out screen where they can select from phone book options. All will display all contacts. Contact Center will default to the phone book entries in the admin portal. Agents is a list of all agents currently logged in. Company is a list of all Connect users, not necessarily users assigned to Engage. When using the phone book option, you will notice a presence icon next to any agents that will make you aware of the agent's availability or status. This icon also lives in the bottom left corner of the application next to the agent's image. To the right, outbound caller ID can also be selected if there are multiple options to choose from. If the agent chooses not to complete this task, cancel can be selected at the top of the window. When receiving a call, the agent will be alerted in the Engage tab. If classifications are turned on in the account, the Classifications tab will display. The agent can navigate freely between the available tabs. As previously mentioned, agents can utilize other various functions in Connect. For example, if the agent is on a call and would like to reach out to a fellow team member for advice, they could simply select the chat option, ask a question, and return to the Engage window. If they decided to transfer the caller over to another agent, select Transfer, automatically placing the caller on hold, and select from the choices of destination. Note, IVR and queue options are only available if these are set in the admin portal as viable transfer options for agents. Once again, the cancel option is available. Some Engage agent features are not yet available for voice calls in the all-in-one solution. If your business needs require preferred agent routing, customer info options, or other features not yet available, you will need to continue using the Engage agent. As with using the Engage agent with a phone, always remember that Engage agent functionalities are separate. Performing actions like call transfer should only be completed within the Engage portion of the application. Upon ending the call, assuming classifications are complete if mandatory, Close Interaction and Go Available becomes blue and can be used to place the agent back in queue, or the drop-down menu can be clicked to select from other status options. Remember, if wrap time is set in the admin portal to send agent back to available after an amount of time is reached, the agent will automatically be set to available when the time expires. Although Engage is an application separate of the Connect phone, the integration has the added feature of presence. Presence allows one agent to be able to see the activity of another. This feature changes the usual functionality of Engage in that using your Connect phone to place calls will affect your status in Engage. Be aware of this detail, as using a phone with the Engage agent will not be affected the same way. Similar to taking calls, agents that are part of a chat queue can also take chats and SMS messages to chat in the unified application. If an agent is logged into a chat queue, chats will appear to the left of the window. As with call notifications, chat notification pop-ups and sounds can be turned on or off from Settings, Application Settings. Navigate here and check or uncheck the appropriate boxes as desired. Once a chat is received, the agent simply needs to respond to the chat and they will become part of the chat. If the chat happens to be an SMS chat, there will be an SMS identifier located by the chat. While performing chats, the agent will have the option to stop new chats. This feature is designed to prevent new chats coming to this agent as, by design, agents are allowed to take multiple chats as set in the admin portal. When on multiple chats, the agent can navigate back and forth through each chat that they are attending to by clicking on the chats to the left. Individual chats will be identified across the top of the chat window by chat name or SMS number. When an agent receives an SMS message, the initiating chat will be in yellow to notify the agent that this is the beginning of the session. This is by design, as SMS messaging will display a message history. By nature, SMS interactions are not always immediate and can carry on throughout the day or even into the next day. This history will allow any agent that is available and may be continuing with the SMS client to follow the history of the interaction. Beneath the chat message pane, you will see an icon for predefined messages. Predefined messages can be created in the admin portal by users with access. Predefined messages are created to help speed a process of responding to chat inquiries by agents. Clicking on this icon, an agent will see all predefined messages that have been assigned to chat queues that they are a part of. On the right pane, you will see customer information. For SMS, information is limited, but for chats, you can see information that is asked of the client, as well as device data such as IP addresses, browser, and operating system platform. You should now understand how to perform voice and chat SMS interactions using the Engage tab in the Unified Desktop application. Thanks for watching.
Orchestrating a Brighter World, NEC.